So you're in Louisville. You are going to pick up one passenger, one male. Super. That is what I want you to pick up. Good morning, everyone. Dave from the wee hours here, back with some more Railroad Corporation as we try to get hot steel to Cincinnati in a very slow and roundabout way by building up a basic trading infrastructure so we can afford to get hot steel to Cincinnati. We're not even close to that yet. We set up our two basic train lines last time. We've got this little route going Lakeville over to Bowling Green, and then way over to Louisville over here. And it's doing some very basic stuff very slowly. And part of that problem that came up in the comments was weight. This train is terrible, and it has a very hard time hauling any weight. We saw in the last one, it took almost 3 game months for it to haul some planks of wood from Bowling Green to Louisville. So a good suggestion came up about shaving down the weight while still trying to maintain profitability is that we are currently, the T1, our first train, is currently hauling from Bowling Green 2 loads of lumber over there, and that is just max weight. It's at 40 out of 40 tons. Max speed is 4 out of 35 miles an hour. It's going 4 miles an hour to Louisville. I know for a fact you could actually walk to Louisville faster. Pick up some wood, walk it over there quicker than this train. So, good suggestion that came up, and I wanted to check this over in Louisville. Does Louisville have a demand for passengers? Yes, they do. Yes, there is a demand for passengers. They supply them and they demand them. So everybody wants people over there, which is super. So what if in Bowling Green, instead of loading 2 things of wood, you loaded 1 thing of wood and 1 passenger? How does that max out in terms of weight? That brings it down. Where did Bowling Green go? No, don't unload that. No. Load. I want you to load a passenger. There we go. That's a little bit more like it. Even though these passengers are somehow absurdly heavy at 12 tons a piece, it's a lot better than the 2 things of wood. So now we're going to move 21 miles an hour. That's over 5 times faster than we are moving. We'll see what that works out to in terms of money. We didn't make no money with that lumber. Yes, it took us 3 months to get over there. But we made, I believe, if I'm remembering correctly, like $8,000 getting that lumber over there, which isn't nothing. And we only have 28, so making 8 is kind of a big deal in our world right now. So we'll see how that works out. We're obviously going to move much, much quicker with 1 thing of wood and 1 passenger. We'll see how that plays out. And I just have to adjust in Louisville what they're going to unload. So you are going to not have 1 or 2 things of wood. You are instead going to unload a passenger. Okay, hopefully I've done that all correctly. So let me just check one more time. In Lakeville, you're going to pick up the raw wood. You're going to bring it over to Bowling Green, where it will unload the raw wood. In Bowling Green, you're going to pick up 1 thing of planks and 1 passenger. You're going to take that over to Louisville, where you are going to drop off 1 thing of planks and 1 passenger. And then you are going to load up, not three pa do we get 3 passengers? That's max 15 miles an hour. What happens if we shave a passenger off? Way quicker. Way quicker. Let's see if speed makes us more profitable than bulk. So you're going to pick up 2 passengers. You're going to bring those back to Bowling Green, where they're going to unload those 2 passengers. Right. Let's actually turn the game on and see how that goes down. And then over here in New Orleans, we've just got a very, very simple route of some coal going from New Orleans to Bowling Green. Very, very straightforward stuff. I'm not going to build it right now. I'm just sort of doing a planning phase of how much it would cost to get the rail from New Orleans over to Barnstable Town. 36K. Wow, that's a lot of money. And that's with our 10% discount that we get for the company that we're working for. Okay, cancel that. Definitely cancel that. We're not doing that. We can't afford that. We do have a little bit of a buffer zone, sort of an overdraft protection thing going on here, but I'd rather not invoke it if we don't have to. I'd rather see if we can do this just on our own merit, on our own money, on our own financials. So at some point, I'll want to, because I believe that's probably the shortest route for coal to Barnstable Town, which is where the steel mill is. I think that's probably the closest place we're going to get coal from. Yeah, it certainly looks like it. So at some point, I'll probably spin this rail over to Barnstable Town from New Orleans and change this train to go over there to take the coal. Right now, I just want to make some money with the coal, but eventually we're going to need that over there to make the steel to take to Cincinnati. Oh, I'm very excited. I found the speedy up button. I found the time button. It was just clicking this multiple times. I never saw that. Usually it's in a line. That's fine. It's in a perfectly appropriate spot, and I should have figured that out for myself, which I just did, actually. So I found the speedy up time thing. Oh, this is so exciting. Good. Now things will move faster. And now we can kind of check out the first little experimental run of this new setup. So right now, the T1 has... Did you get all your things? Yes, you got all your things. You have one thing of planks and one thing of passengers. Let's see how much... You're obviously moving quite a bit faster. In fact, I'd like to turn it back down to regular mode. Yeah, you are moving so much faster now. So much faster. Although I see the condition of the train is a little bunk. That's not so good. That's going to be money in repairs that I don't really have the money to be spending. But let's see how much money we make when we pull into here. Oh, I found the speedy up button. I'm very excited about this. Good. Let's see how much money we make when we pull into Louisville with this new little setup. So just getting into Louisville here, we're going to make how much? Unload your stuff. Okay, $85.80. That's it? That's all we made on that? Because we made basically twice that with the lumber. And then we just spent a bunch of money in repairs. I mean, we are gaining money, but not as much as I'd like. Is that because the passenger? Do you just... You say you have a demand for passengers. Price per 100 miles is $300. Okay, so we're probably just not making a lot of money on passengers. Let me see if I can get a broad look at our financial picture. Yeah, we definitely did better in the first quarter, quite a bit better actually with that lumber. This is the best sort of financial breakdown I can get right now that I can lay my hands on. So we're making less money, but are we doing it faster? So overall, is this more profitable to do these things faster? I don't know. Let's get this back going back on here and let's put it into double time march here. Right. What else can I do with $43,000? Well, could start upgrading the old office here. We need to upgrade that. We have these little building slots. It's 10 grand to upgrade the first slot, and we need three to get the research station that we actually need. Technology investments, set up a research and development office. We can't do that until we get three slots open. I probably should just spend the 10 grand now, because I'm actually really interested to see if the next tier of that is going to be even more expensive. I believe it will be. So, yeah, okay, I'll take that. All right, now what? Oh, okay, now I just have four open slots. I assumed every upgrade would be one more building slot. Clearly, I've been playing a little too much Total War lately, but no, I've unlocked all five of them. So cool, I could set up my research department, well, when I've got the money to do it. How much is it to do that? It is 5 grand, and I've got the three rooms. Okay, that's not as bad as I thought. Run locomotive technology research. Okay, we will probably do that sooner rather than later once a few of these trains just do a couple more runs here, because I think we can cover that. And I just want to see how the coal route is doing and see if this is worthwhile to keep it going, because it is just a one-way trip. We're not bringing anything back to New Orleans, unfortunately. Yeah, it's not a small amount of money. That's like $8,000 for that, for a fairly quick route. It would be great if New Orleans demanded something so I could do stuff back and forth, but they don't. But $8,000 for that is not bad. I'm going to keep that ticking along. And I'm going to keep my new wood and passenger thing ticking along. Louisville no longer demands wood. Oh, okay. Hold the phone. Hold the phone here. Hold the phone. What's your problem, Louisville? Why? Why are you messing with me, Louisville? Okay, no, wait a minute. I'm just misunderstanding the difference between wood and lumber. They still demand lumber. They just don't want wood. That's fine. I'm not sending you any. It's totally okay. I'm sending you lumber, so you should still have a demand for that. I'd really like to get a mail train going, because mail seems to be a lot of money for, you know, mail. It's 500 per 100 miles, and it's got to be nice and light. Of course, that's what I thought about human beings, but apparently they're 12 tons each in this game. So if I could find somewhere that provides mail, which unfortunately Bowling Green does not, nobody is writing letters from Bowling Green. This is the most antisocial town ever. It's just a closed-off, walled-in, gated community that wants nothing to do with the outside world and isn't sending anyone any mail at all. Which is sad, because Louisville would really like to get some mail. They'd love to have some mail. They do provide mail. They do provide mail, so I could get some mail going from there. But Bowling Green has no desire for mail because they hate everyone, apparently. Just taking a fresh look at the financials, I really should have waited until the second quarter closed out, because we actually did fine. Second quarter for 1833 is much better than the first quarter, so I think changing that route to change it to wood and passengers, just making everything move faster, was a great move. Good comment there. Thank you to my comment section, as always, for holding my hand through basically every game I play. Best friend has broken down. Oh dear. What do we do about that? Do we send someone? Is there, like, AAA for trains? How do we deal with that? Oh, and what's Clarksville got going on these days? Sorry, distracted. You just kind of have the basics. If somebody brought you some wheat, you'd make some meat. I don't really have a wheat source right at this exact second. What do we do about the broken down train? Do we send somebody to deal with that? Where is my T1 right now? Hang on. Yeah, let's see where the trains are. Where are you? Okay, it seems to have rectified itself, so mysterious invisible AAA for trains in 1833 has dealt with the problem without me dealing with it, but it did kind of shut down the route for what was probably game weeks at that point. So, okay, I think the best move, now that I see that we are basically making money, he says tentatively, is to get this research station going, because what I bet you we can research, if I know my tycoon games, is better trains. And that will probably solve a lot of problems that we're having. So let's set up a new office department. I'm going to install the research and development project. R&D is a go. We can improve our locomotives or even develop new ones. 5 research projects will be enough to keep our company updated. Is that like a new thing now? Do I have to do 5 projects? New locomotive, improve the existing ones, you decide. Well thought out plan. Oh boy, are you on the wrong channel for that, dude. Oh yeah, you ain't looking to me for well thought out plans. Ensure that research ends before the delivery of steel to Cincinnati. Okay, there will be a new shipment, you expect. We'll have to move southward. Okay, so basically finish what I'm doing here, research things before I finish the quest is what I'm hearing there. Hopefully. Okay. T1 and T2 are both active, both basically making money, more or less. What's my next best move? I should probably start researching something, right? Shouldn't I be getting a research project going? Because that's costing me upkeep. Yeah, research. Your company now has a research department with 10 scientists. And the fact that you're highlighting 10 scientists, I'm going to guess means I can update that to have more scientists later. Right? How do I research something, sir? Probably right up here in the research department screen. Yes. Ooh, a big old tech tree. I like a big old tech tree. Okay, what have we got going on here? What do I have to deal with here? Now, it looks like it's going to be a while before I can unlock a new locomotive, the John Bull over here. Not even worth really looking at the stats, because it's probably going to be ages before I get there. So the locomotive best friend, which is what we're working with now, is kind of my central thing here. I don't know. If I start researching this now, because I'm not a stranger to a tech tree. I have seen many a tech tree in many games in my time. So if I go locomotive best friend, will that automatically shoot me over to locomotive's power when I'm done with it? Or, given all the supply lines here, do I have to unlock all of these other things before I can move forward to locomotive's power, which would then move me forward to the John Bull? I think, well, I don't know. What I'd like to do is just start with some basic stuff that we can knock out that will be beneficial right now, and it's all pretty beneficial. Reliability, obviously, it would be great if this thing was more reliable, considering it just broke down. Power would be good. That'll get it a little better acceleration time. Max speed, that'd be nice, wouldn't it? Fuel consumption, that'll just save me money. More efficient fuel burning reduces locomotive fuel consumption. Yeah, that's what the hint was in the title there, game. So that is just going to broadly save me money forever. And that's what we did when we picked the company. We went with that 10% discount to all train tracks every time, which is just a broad good thing. I kind of want to go this way. I think I'm going to start with the power. Let's get these things a little bit more power or reliable. They're all good. I'm also looking at pulling mass as well, which will up the pulling mass by 10 tons, but I don't think that's the most valuable thing I can be doing, because it seems virtually everything weighs over 10 tons, so I might not even be able to get an extra load of anything, and it's just going to slow everything down. I'm going to take power. That's going to be my starting one. Yeah, power, get that going, scientist guys, in your awesome steampunk-esque lab coats there. Go ahead and do that, and then we'll kind of see how long it takes. How long is this thing going to take? Do I have an idea on that? 237 days. Okay. So you guys ain't super quick about this, are ya? Now, our other train broke down. There it is. Okay, now I can see what's going on. Right, so somebody shows up and it's just a matter of, well, real time, actual time before they repair it. Okay, that's fair. What I was kind of bouncing around with, what I didn't see in the research department at the time, is I can assign the number of scientists. Okay, so if I keep bumping this, oh yeah, we can blaze through this. How about we have 10. Let's do 5 scientists on that, and let's do 5 scientists on reliability. So give me all the rest of my scientists in that. Okay, now I'm getting the hang of this a little tiny bit, he says optimistically. Oh, I gotta watch the money, though. These things aren't completely cheap to research, but now they're just flying through this. Great, good, good information there. I'm kind of thinking, depending on the money situation, we start, you go away right now. We start spinning a track over to Barnstable Town from New Orleans. Because we're going to have to do it at some point. It's inevitable. That is, as far as I can see, that is the closest route to get coal to any steam, or steam. We're not constructing steam, we're constructing steel. Get coal to a steel mill. That's probably the closest route. I think the other steel mill was somewhere over here, maybe. Maybe not at all. Maybe I was just looking at coal and iron. Aha! On December 1833, Bowling Green has opened its doors to the wider world and now demands mail. Good. I have a plan for that. Actually, go ahead back to regular slow mode game. Now, I'm bringing passengers, but mail is actually, well, let's go back to Bowling Green. So the T1, which is now from, Louisville, hauling passengers back to Bowling Green. Are passengers worth more or less than mail? So you demand mail 500 per 100 miles. Passengers are cheaper. So really, I should be getting mail from... Yeah, give me my T1. Give me my T1. All right, in Louisville, you are no longer going to load passengers. Instead, I want you to load mail. And it's 15 tons for mail? How heavy are these letters? They're just letters, you can see. It's an icon of a letter. It can't possibly weigh 15 tons. Okay, how much can I squeeze on there? At 2 of them, that's still a decent speed. That's 24 miles an hour. That's fine. You know what? I'm going to take that. I'll take that hit. Because it should be a little bit more money every time it makes the stop. So in Louisville, you're going to unload those planks. You're going to load up the mail and bring it back. Oh, I got to tell it to... Hang on. Are we paused? Pause, please. Things are happening. We researched our thing. So in Bowling Green, I need you to unload mail. Yes, I need you to unload mail. I suppose I could have just kept the passengers on there. There just wouldn't be any to unload. But yeah, unload 2 mails, please. I wonder if I could just set up everything. I'm thinking of this more like Interstellar Transport Company that we just played on the channel, where you can just say, hey, you know what? Unload whatever you got and drop it off. But let's see. So you're going to load mail in Louisville. You're going to unload it in Bowling Green. Knock yourselves out, kids. We'll see how that works out money-wise. And we finished some research. We should go address that. We got power. Let's Well, we've already completed the locomotive best friend. Apparently, we just sort of started with that. If I can I just go over? Apparently, I can just go right over to all locomotives power. Okay, sure. If I can just skate over into a new train, I'm 100% fine with that. I may pick off some more of these other ones too, because they're all really handy. I mean, they're all good, but let's see what happens. The T2 broke down again. We should probably invest more of our research into reliability and lifespan. We'll have a look at that when the next research project completes. I'm kind of thinking we knew it cost, what, about 36,000 to spin that track over to Barnstable Town. I'm thinking I should just go ahead and build it while I've got the money, and we are technically making money. How are we doing? Fourth quarter was not so great. Neither was the third quarter. I wonder what was going on there. I mean, we are spending more money. We're spending money on research projects and things, but that's a big drop. Still technically profitable, but a big drop nonetheless. Well, maybe we'll make all our money in mail. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna take the chance on spinning the track over there. I'm gonna need it at some point. It's not like we're not going to build this. This is not a whim. So let's see if we can get this to go in a reasonably sensible manner. Maybe right through that rock. There we go. 36K on that. No, I'm gonna have to spend it at some point. There it is. Spent a ton of money. It's probably an upkeep charge for these tracks. There's got to be, right? Scrap it? No. Okay. I don't specifically see an upkeep charge here on this. Maybe in, I wish I had a slightly better, more detailed financial section, accounting report. Kind of like to see exactly what I'm spending on what. Boy, this T2 is going down almost every single time it makes a trip now. This is really in rough shape. I know it's broken. Maybe I'll just get a new train? No, because those are like 14,000 and I've only got 25 right now. Not really sure how to address that at the moment. Not quite sure what is going on with the T1. The T1 seems to have gone back to a very old load and unload thing. I'm not sure if I did that myself, which is entirely possible. I just clicked the wrong thing and reset it to something older, or if it's just a bug or a glitch. But this is like our first route that we had set up, and this is not what we want. We want this. We want one thing of lumber and one passenger from Bowling Green to load. I'm not really sure what happened here. I'm gonna reset all of this. You're gonna go over to Louisville. You're gonna unload one wood and you're gonna unload one passenger because that's what you're picking up in Bowling Green. And while you're there, you're not doing any of this. You're doing one passenger and one thing of mail. And then in Bowling Green, you're not doing any of this. You're doing a thing of mail. I'm not sure what happened there, and I keep saying that over and over. I'm not sure if I clicked something or if it's just a bug or a glitch. I would like to think it's the latter, but given my experience, it's probably the former. I probably just didn't hit apply. So let's make sure we do that. Okay, everything seems to be all right. And that means the T1 was just stalled there. So we just lost a lot of profitability doing that. Now, is it moving now? Are you picking stuff up and going to do a thing? I see part of the other problem too. It's got its passenger, but there's no lumber. There's no lumber from the sawmill. Yeah, something has kind of gone critically wrong here. I'm not entirely sure what it is. For right now, just take the, you know what? Take another passenger, I guess, over to Louisville. And then we'll figure it out. We'll figure it out when you get back. Is the sawmill not producing wood? No, sawmill's got wood. Sawmill totally has wood. And while all this was going on, our research finished too. Okay, so we have no active research. Right. Yeah, boy, these get pretty pricey when you get up here. 7,400 for the next train. How about we do some a little bit less expensive ones that'll still benefit us, like fuel consumption, That's a good one to do. We'll just, less money on fuel is less money, period. So start doing that. And how about pulling mass? Yeah, we'll take this now. I'll take it now. That'll be an extra 10 tons. That might be, maybe we can squeeze on an extra thing of mail. Oh, not seven of you, five of you. There you go. And five on you. There we go. Okay, do that. And then we'll try and figure out what's gone horribly wrong with the T1 here. Okay, the T1 is off and running again, which is great, and moving fairly quickly. That's probably why we weren't making so much money. I wasn't paying attention to the T1, and it was just stalled out there on an earlier load-unload problem. Okay, well, we'll just kind of try and pick it up and plug along as we go along here. Or we would if the T1 didn't break down on the way. Okay, well, train AAA will be there shortly, I'm sure. And now that I'm thinking about it, there's no particular reason the T2 can't start running coal over to Barnstable now. It's still money. I don't need to send it to my own town. It's still, 4,400 per load. It'll take us probably a little bit longer. It's probably a slightly longer route, but not a lot. Not a lot longer. Okay, T1, we need to address you before we do any of that. Let me just get you into, there you go, you're in there. Now, pause it. So you're in Louisville, you are going to pick up one passenger, one mail. Super, that is what I want you to pick up. And in Bowling Green, you are going to unload a passenger and mail, and you'll unload wood, etc., etc., etc. Yeah, okay, good. In Lakeville, you're going to pick up wood. You're not going to unload anything because Lakeville doesn't need anything. Bowling Green, you're going to unload the wood and turn it into planks, hopefully. Right? You guys are still working over here, right? Okay. And then in Louisville, you're going to, you will take one plank and one passenger over to Louisville. If there's planks here, it's kind of the problem. Okay, fair enough. We'll keep an eye on that as best as I can. So yeah, there's no real reason I can't just tell the T2 to go over to Barnstable. It's virtually the same distance. I bet if you laid these tracks out, they'd be pretty darn close. T1 is broken down again. That is twice now. I think we need a new train. I think we got to replace the T1 with, the T3. Basically, this thing is just wrecking itself. So everybody slow down a sec there. T2, let me just get you into the train station. There you go. Okay, pause that. Let's fidget with the T2 here. So we'll just get rid of Bowling Green and add Barnstable Town. There we go. Where you are going to unload two coal. Boom. Done. Apply that. Off you go, Sparky. It's money one way or another. We may as well start this whole getting steel to Cincinnati thing. And with that underway, and with plans for the T1, we'll probably call it on Railroad Corporation for today, and we'll pick up some more next time. We're kind of got the foundations of our hot steel to Cincinnati thing done. Now we got to figure out where we're going to get iron from. Winchester, I'm looking in your direction over there, and see if we can sort out all the issues with our main route here and make sure that's going to run fairly smoothly. Right, we'll do that all in Railroad Corporation next time. Hey, if you enjoyed the video, do please leave a like down below. It does cheer me up no end when people do that. And if you're new to the channel, maybe just checking it out for the first time, feel free to hit that subscribe button. See more of this ridiculous nonsense. Until then, I'm Dave. Thank you, as always, for joining me in the wee hours, and we'll see you next time.